So to make the templates for the window covers, I have just got some newspaper and stuck it to the window and then traced very carefully all the way around the edge. And then I can take this and trace this onto my materials. So it's taken a couple of hours, but I've now traced out and made cardboard templates of all of the windows. Slightly annoyingly, this window and this window are not mirror images, so that's had a separate one. But that window and that window are the same, and that window and that window are the same. And then I've got another template for this window. So the next task is to go and start marking all of this out and cutting out the fabric. Okay, so today we're looking at window covers, and for this van I wanted some decent thermal covers because we've got so many windows in it, and try and reduce some of the heat loss. There are some really, really nice ones out there, but ones for our van would have been well in excess of £1,000 for all of them, because we've got 8 windows. So I decided to have a go at making my own, and this is one of 2 that I've made already. This is for the driver's door, and it's got a silver coating on the outside which will help reflect radiated heat from the sun, and it's got thin slate insulation and then a lightweight ripstop nylon. So let me just show you all of them close up. So this here is a silver pigmented PU fabric, so it's relatively heavy, and theoretically I could have used this both sides, but it's about twice the weight as the ripstop nylon, and these covers are already going to be quite heavy. Then the insulation is Thinsulate branded insulation that would be used for making clothing and stuff. And then the outer face, or inside the van, the face that's inside the van, just something to look tidy, so it's a really lightweight ripstop nylon. Let's try and show you how all those bits go together. Let me just turn this light on. So we've got the PU, and that's going to be the, let's call this the outer layer, it's going to face out towards the outside of the van. Then we've got the thinsulate layer in between, and then the lightweight ripstop nylon on the inside. All I was doing is just throwing a couple of stitch lines, like 200mm apart, just to try and hold the layers together. Then trace around it with the template, then sew to that line, cut just outside the line, and then put the edge banding on. Now, I'll show you some of the tools I use to do it, because this particular job, if you're trying to do it manually, can take a really long time. It's doable, but there's a couple of things you can add to your sewing machine to make this job much easier. Then, for the cab windows, the driver's side, passenger side, and the windscreen, they're going to be held on with suction cups, so I put these eyelets in. The eyelets I've got and the tool I've got is not very good, but they're on and they're going to work fine. And then for all of the windows in the back, they're going to be using magnets to hold them on. So one of the big jobs to start with is creating cardboard templates. So that probably see, that's the cab windows, and this one's symmetrical, so one side works as driver and the other as passenger. The only one that I've done a half template of, one because it's massive and two because it is actually symmetrical, is the windscreen. You won't be able to see that very well because it's so big, that's upside down. This one can be flipped over to do the two halves of it. All of the others are slightly asymmetrical, so in total there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 templates for 8 windows. So I was kind of hoping more of them would be symmetrical left to right, but there's only the cab windows and the rear windows that work like that. All of the others are slightly different, so that took quite a long time. So once you've made the paper template, trace that onto the cardboard and then try and cut that fairly closely. I mean, it doesn't matter if you a centimetre out here or there. These things are fabric and flexible, but you want to get them looking nice and tidy. Once you've done that, then you need to lay out the three fabrics in a bit of some space, and with a bit of board around the edge, cut out the rough area that will be bigger than your template. So this is why I do such a big overhang to begin with, because I find to get started with these materials before they're kind of sewn together properly, that they can kind of move between the layers move around too easily. So start with plenty of extra, get the first bit on, and at least then the three layers are going to stay together. Then I'm going to mark out 20 centimeter lines with a straight edge. I'll mark it on the silver side. Two reasons for that. One, I can see it on the silver side. When you saw earlier, or if, I don't know if you saw earlier, try to mark the black side, you just can't see it. It actually soaks into the fabric. Also, the black side slides better on the sewing table. But the caveat to that is you need to either have it pinned or a stitch lining first, so that the black layer actually stays in contact with the thinsulate properly. The other thing I'll show you, or hopefully we'll see or not see, is that the black layer, because it's so thin, will easily crinkle, and if you're not careful, you'll stitch a fold into the underside. So I should be regularly checking when I'm sewing the rest of the lines up that I'm not getting creases in here. I did that face down. Now we've got the three layers sewn together, I need to trace around the template. The key here is to make sure we do it the right way around. So although we're making the passenger side, this says driver, that's because the black side is on the inside, passenger window's this way. The eagle eye will spot that this is a different shape to the other one. It's because I cut them the wrong way around when I sewed them together. Thankfully, it's the right size for one of the other covers, so I'll just use it later. But there's a note: do the full size and then cut it down afterwards. Don't try and cut it down beforehand, because you'll waste material if you're not careful. Now that I've got that traced out, I'm going to use my scissors to cut that out. Now that we've got the shape drawn out, I'm going to stitch along that line, and then I'm able to cut just outside that line. Now that we've got the profile sewn out onto it, I'm going to cut within sort of 5mm of that stitch line and try and keep it as close as I can to the pen mark, and then if I've got any wobbles in the stitch line it won't matter because it'll be hidden by the binding. One thing that I've just spotted with this particular cover is that it is almost symmetrical but not quite. So I need to do something on it so that it's so we know which way round it should go, because it can either go this way up on the window or this way up on the window. So I made a note on here so I can see where the bottom is, and I've just got these little bits of bright coloured vinyl, and I'm going to just stitch them onto this bottom just here, and then when I put the binding tape around it you'll just see the top of it, and that'll just be an indication for us so we can easily identify where the bottoms are. To attach the cab covers to the windows, I'm going to use suckers. On the first one that I did, I've been out and worked out the position and where I want the suckers, so all I'm going to do is line these up face to face and then just mark out where I want the holes to go. So for putting the eyelets in, I've got this very cheap eyelet and grommet kit. If I was doing more of these I'd buy a better one. It does work but it's a bit of a pain, and the punch isn't very sharp, and the die isn't quite the right shape. I can make it work for what we need, but it's not great. So to put the eyelet in, you've got base plate, put the eyelet on top, then feed the eyelet onto the hole. Then there's a little top piece that goes on, and then you get the eyelet setting tool. Now I've had, because this is quite thick, I've had a few issues with it crimping down and not catching the top piece, so I actually have to sort of knock it off centre. To give the that's what I mean about this kit not being very good. In fact, let's start again. Okay, so to put the eyelet on, we've got the, I suppose it's an anvil designed for that particular size eyelet, and there's a little washer top cap. Hit it a bit harder to finish it off. So that's in and it's worked. As I say, I'm not a massive fan of these particular eyelets, but it's going to do the job. Now I'll just do the others. So the next stage of making this window cover is to add the binding tape to the edge to make it look smart. This can be, you can do it manually and put it all in place and pin it out, but it takes a really long time. So I have a tape binding attachment for my sewing machine and a different foot, which you can't really see, just has space for it. And it means that the binding tape just feeds into it and makes adding the edging tape really easy, or a lot easier, and makes it really neat and professional looking finish. So I'll try and put this camera in a different position to show you that. Right, I'm just going to stop there, take the binding tape binding attachment off, and just finish this last little bit by hand, just so I can try and get the join between the two bits nice and tidy. So here's the finished cover, and I just need to put the suction cups through the eyelets, and then that one's ready to use. So to make the magnet holders, first thing I'm going to do is to sew some strips of the binding just in half into a loop like this. Then you can slide a magnet in, fold it over and sew it on. So let me just show you that. So the way this works is you just get the magnet, slide it in, make sure it's gone plenty of the way through, then I fold it over. I've put pins in where I want my bits. Now, if I just do that, it's going to stick to the table. So what I do is just get a bit of scrap of fabric, put that under the magnet, and that just helps stop it sticking to the table too much. That's it, other than snapping my thread, and then you just trim the excess off, trim the threads, and that's them done. It is awkward working with magnets because they stick to the table, they stick to the sewing machine, they stick to each other, but what I found is actually things like that where they would stick to the scissors, stick them to the table, then the scissors are free to do what you want, or where they're sticking to the table, use anything to space them off, reduces the strength of the pull, helps them slide, that sort of thing, and soon get a bit of a pattern going, and it works. And then you just set out an even pattern, mirror it onto the other side. I've made every other magnet so it's south, north, north, south, north, so that when they fold they can snap together and hold themselves folded. So now I'll probably just chuck it on time lapse and do the rest. Okay, so here is my pile of covers, all completed. Now I just need to go and test fit them all. So here the rear ones are all fitted. Oops, shut this door so you can see this one. Try not to tread on stuff. Yeah, really happy with how well they fit. The only thing is my magnet placement isn't perfect, so these corners probably could do with them. So I need to order some more magnets, so I use them all up, and I'll just add a couple of magnets in all the top corners on them, but that's not too big an issue. So overall, really happy with them. Yeah, so having done that job now, I understand why you see the sets, especially over in America, where the, for a full set for a van this size, you're talking something like $1,200. And I understand why. I mean, that's been three, four full days' work and a couple hundred pounds worth of materials. For us, I think it's worth it because it's done really nice.